you through how to draft your own 2D patterns in the 2D window and briefly explain the tools. We actually have an entire pattern drafting class that's 16 weeks long, where we really dive deep into pattern drafting. But here I'm just going to show you the tools, like how to use actual tools to draw different pattern shapes. So you're going to want to be in your 2D window side, and you're going to notice here we have the polygon tool, letter H. I'm going to click and hold that guy down. So we have a rectangle shape, ellipse, and even a spiral if you wanted to draft some kind of crazy fancy flounce shape. But the polygon is just going to draw any random shape that you want just by clicking and clicking, kind of like the pen tool in Adobe Illustrator, honestly. So all four of these tools are going to make a pattern piece, okay? A brand new pattern piece. Underneath it, if you aren't already familiar, is an internal line. These can draw lines on top of your pattern piece. And internal lines have like the power to be smart. They can be sew lines. They can be cut lines. They can be all kinds of stuff. And then below that, if you guys ever need it, is just the base tools, the baselines, and you can draw this on top of pattern pieces also. They don't really do anything other than just our reference points there for you. So to draft a pattern, you're gonna wanna use this tool right here, keyboard shortcut H, okay? And the way it goes, you can just like click, let me make sure I'm in it, H, click, there we are. You can go click with your mouse, click, you know, click, click, click at the end. And it just knew that that was your last one. When you hover over the first point that you made, it automatically closed it, and there's your pattern piece. But let's say you want to do a curve. I'm going to hit the letter A. It's actually already selected. I'm going to hit delete. I'm going to go back to the letter H, which is our little keyboard shortcut to drafting patterns. If you know you have a curve, you can also actually click and drag, and it's really a lot like the Illustrator pen tool, if you guys are familiar with that. I'm gonna click here one time to get rid of that handlebar, click, come down here, and maybe do a little click and drag, maybe get rid of that preempted handlebar that they give you, and then click to finish. And then you can hit the letter Z if you wanna go back in and, you know, play with your handlebars to kind of fix stuff, fix individual anchor points, all that good stuff. And if you haven't figured out already, if you need to change the length of something, you can click it with the left mouse when you're in the letter Z tool, right click, and there is the change length tool. You have the choice to change it at the start, the length, or you can change it at the end, make it go longer at the bottom, or you can split it in between both, the start and then. So that's a good thing to play around with. Let's say you do know your measurements. You don't want to just like randomly eyeball this guy. You can go back to H, and you know how wide your hem is, you know, or your waist, you know your waist needs to be 5.75 inches. You can right click and you can type in 5.75. So that, and they even have like a mirror thing, which is kind of cool. All kinds of stuff to play with to kind of get you drawing. So if you just need to right click, that's an option as well. Okay, but how do we get those measurements? I mean, maybe you are actually using some kind of POM sheet that you have in front of you. Maybe you don't, and you just need to get measurements from your avatar, who happens to be standing right here. You can pull out her measurements to look at it. Now, don't be confused with garment measuring tools versus avatar measuring tools. You want to make sure you get the avatar one. And I work on a small screen because I like to take my laptop, throw it in my purse. So a lot of my tools get kind of collapsed and they can be hard to find. So just click on these little arrows. That's not it. That's a button tool. That's some kind of folding tool. Oh, here we are. Here's a measuring tool. I think it's for the avatar. I'm going to hover. Okay. It's not even letting me hover over it. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to pull it out. It's a little tricky to pull. I mean, it's easy once you know what to do, but it's very particular. You have to hover over this solid line and see how my mouse changed to a cross. That's like bingo. When you see that, you click and drag with your left mouse and see how I'm pulling out the tool. They even open up a little side menu bar for me. I'm just gonna drag and drop it there. And there we go. Now I got a whole nother menu. I could put more tools there if I wanted. I've also seen them where like the menu's been over here on the other side or up high. Like you can put it wherever the heck you want. Okay, I think I'm okay. Just go there. Ah, Okay, fine. It's at the top. Okay, I'm going to hover over this guy because I always like to double check the name of my tools. Here, I'll click the background once. And let's see. Basic circumference, measure avatar. Yes, we want the avatar tool. Now, don't forget, when you see this white arrow, that means it's going to edit. And if it doesn't have the white arrow, it's going to draw it most likely. So, and then also if there's a little arrow at the bottom, you can click and pull that out and you can see some other options. So really in this case, there's all these different ways to measure your avatar. I think I want to get her waist measurements, so I'll just do the basic circumference and I'm going to zoom in and I guess I'll just take this measurement by clicking on it. And so I'm going to switch to the edit tool to like select or click on it. So, and it's a little picky. Come on, there, light up. Oh, it almost lit. Click. When I saw it light up, that's when I'm going to click it. Okay, so it's at 31.187 inches. So I had that measurement. If I want to do it, the math to figure out the waist of her skirt. So maybe I want the front to be 15 and a half inches, or maybe a little bit bigger. Maybe I want it to be 15 and three-fourths inches. So then that way I can go use my H tool. I can click. Maybe I click and drag. Oops. Actually, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to click. I'm going to right click. I'm going to change it to 5.75. And it looks like I haven't figured out how to do the curve tool and put in the measurement. So if anyone knows how to do that, do tell. Let me know. So, here, like, so if I click and drag and then right click. Oh, there it goes. That's how you do it. I did it. Okay. So, oh, but it's doing it for the handlebar. I don't really care about that. No. Okay, I want the handlebar to go away. You can always do change length, like I said later, if you're having issues with that. Okay, so that's basically it. If you guys wanted to add a dart, you can add a point. The keyboard shortcut is the letter X. I remember that so easily because it's right next to A and Z, which we use all the time. A is the selection tool, so Z is like the direct selection tool, like the edit pattern one, and then add a point or split a line is right next to it, X. So you can just add a little point. Again, I just clicked it. I could have right-clicked it to really say where I want it. And I love how it's color-coded. Like line one is yellow and the blue one is this. And it tells you how big they are. So you can type in that. Oh, and by the way, this one went all the way around. That's interesting. So, okay. So anyways, once you have a point there, you can then select it with just your Z tool, right-click, and you can say add dart. All kinds of different things. So play around with those tools, enter, and they're there for you. So I just wanted to briefly introduce drawing a 2D pattern shape. So you're really going to use this H tool a lot, and then you're going to go back to your Z tool to kind of clean stuff up, maybe add more points as well. And cleaning up curves, there's different curve tools. Play around with them, but this is just a really short introduction to drafting your own patterns if you need to.